If you've just beaten Scarstorch of Dan and ventured off down a comet-sized hole, you hopefully have found yourself one of, if not the most powerful spirit summons in the game, the Mimic's Tear. If you've not quite managed to obtain a Mimic's Tear, I'd highly advise watching my other video on that one, as a lot of the areas we'll be visiting today will not be detailed on how to reach them in this video. They are, however, detailed in the Mimic Tear video. Later on in this video, we are going to be visiting some new areas, and those are going to be recorded and detailed in this video. The good news is Ghost Glove War 1-4 can actually be found right before the Mimic Tear boss fight. 1-3 can be purchased from the Twin Maiden Husks in the round table once you give them the Ghost Glove War Picker's Bell bearing 1, which is located on the body right outside Nokron Eternal City Grace. Whilst in this courtyard, just on the west side of a building on the furthest southwest, is a Ghost Glove War 3, to save you a little bit of money. Also here is a Ghost Glove War 4. Next we're going to teleport to the Ancestral Woods Grace once more, but this time we're not jumping off onto the rooftops, we're heading over to the hills to the northeast. Whilst trying to avoid the pack of wolves and the red wolf, you'll hopefully find a group of rats and two singing cow lady tribesmen. I really have no idea what to call these things. But if you find these, you are in the right location. You'll see that just past the mobs is a little area you can jump to get your Ghost Glove War 5. Ghost Glove War 6, 7, 8, 9 and the Great Ghost Glove War, which is the 10th, are all actually in the exact same location, but will require a questline to be partially completed and an easy boss defeated. We're going to make a long journey along the left side of the map. Those of you who have followed my how to get a plus 9 somber weapon before killing any boss will have already been to see our giant blacksmith friend. If not, here's a really quick guide showing you how to get there. From here, we're heading further up the path towards the north-northeast, where we're going to head into a castle area with some of my least favourite mobs, tarantula hands. However, if you need a load of Somber Smithstone 2s, they have a 100% drop rate for them for whatever reason. The run is pretty straightforward, and I don't really think there's many locations to deviate off to on this map, so I'm just going to speed this part up and make sure not to cut any out. There isn't going to be a map overlay for this area as it's pretty small and I'm hoping you can follow along easy enough with just video evidence. Feel free to let me know if this wasn't as easy to follow and I'll prove this to my future guides. The boss is actually relatively easy, it does a lot of very large but telegraphed attacks. With your Mimic in tow, it's just a case of splitting the aggro and getting off some big hits when you can. Gonna say that this boss is immune to blood loss, just looking at it, it doesn't have any skin, blood, or anything, it's kinda just ghostly. After defeating the boss, head out into a magical crystal area where you'll be greeted by a dragon. Either ignore it or fight it, which you'll be hearing a lot of in this video. I decided to fight it because it actually flies off around 50% health. In this area is going to be 3 towers. All but one is actually currently blocked off by a magical seal, so scale the only tower that you actually have access to. At the top, you'll either meet an old friend, or if you're like me and unfortunately forgot to visit her at the church, you'll be meeting a mage for the first time. Her name is Rani, though she introduces herself as Renna originally. We're going to be doing a part of her questline to obtain the rest of our items, though a slight spoiler warning ahead. After one or two questlines, she mentions that Blythe was on a mission to obtain a certain item for her. It's actually the item that we were tasked with ourselves to fetch. So a little warning out there, this may actually affect Blythe's questline, but I can't say for certain as I've never actually done Blythe's questline. To obtain the item we need, once again visit Nokron Eternal City, and head to where we obtained Mimic's Tear. From here, you are jumping down and either run past or kill the big ball. I killed it as they actually drop a larval tear for the first time you defeat them. And a good tip for killing this one, kite it back to the corner where it doesn't seem to be able to hit you. Get off some free damage while you stay safe in the corner. Exit out and head towards the next grace, and for some reason you're able to summon your mimic here. So I did for the hell of it. Me and the mimic then cleared out all of the slimes until we got to the big one, where my mimic just noped out of there. After killing the giant, head up towards the actual giant and look for the dagger in the chest inside. You'll also find your great glove wart here. Head back to Rani and give her the dagger. Head straight back to the top of the tower, where hopefully Rani is no longer there. If she is there for some reason, just exhaust her dialogue again, teleport and reset, and head back up to the top of the tower. Now she should definitely be gone, and a grace is actually left in her place. When you grab this grace, you'll notice that this grace is pointing towards the east. So head back down the tower and head over to the furthest east tower. You'll notice the seal is gone and you can head up a ladder. Carefully head around the tower and at the top you'll find a teleporter. This takes you to a somewhat high level area and the mobs here are actually stagger resistant, which is a huge pain. But it's worth looking around this area before progressing as you'll find various ghost glove warts, starting with a couple of sixes and eventually you'll find a seven. Kill the giant laser skull centipede thing. Seriously, FromSoft, where do you guys get these ideas from? I don't know how to describe half of these mobs. And then head behind it, and you're probably best off avoiding the ants. Run down the water towards the dam, and then go through the hole in the wall on the left. This will take you to the next area of Nokron, and I've got some good news for you. The 8 and the 9 that you actually need are really close, and you don't need to venture too far into this area. Grab the grace, and do not go up the stairs. Instead, in the river is an ant-riding mob, and as with all of the mobs that are coming up, either kill them or run past it. But a quick warning, there are a lot of mobs in this area and you will get swarmed if you pull too many. I would advise trying to kill them. After the Ant Rider, there's actually 2 more mobs with strange looking weapons. They look close range, but the weapons actually extend, which caught me off guard. Kill them and head down the river. There's a load of mage snails on the right, which I went out of my way to kill just to be safe, and I'd advise you do the same. After the snails, head into the river and start killing off some of the slimes. Note that a lot of them will explode dealing lightning damage around them, but I actually used this to my advantage and used it to kill off the other slimes. Against the wall is your Ghost Glove Wart 8. From here keep heading down the river and we're actually heading to the building on the left, so if you're confident make a run for it. Inside you'll find a lift and going down it will lead you straight to the Ghost Glove Wart 9 and a grace. And there you have it. Ghost Glove Wart 1 to 10, and I'd argue this is possibly the earliest that you can do it. Requiring only 3 bosses killed, Radahn, Mimic's Tear, and Loretta. So if this video helps at all, please consider liking, commenting, and subscribing. Thank you.